This video will show you how to simulate a CCT diagram for gamma prime precipitation in a nickel chromium aluminum alloy using the precipitation module known as TC-PRISMA. The CCT calculation type was introduced into Thermo-Calc in the 2017B release, so I will be using this version of the software while I explain this new calculation type. The calculation is based on Precipitation Module Example 7, which can be accessed from within Thermo-Calc in the Help menu, Open Examples, Precipitation Module TC-PRISMA. To begin the calculation, click on the Precipitation Simulation template to get all the nodes we need for a precipitation calculation. Set the database package to Demo Nickel-Based Superalloys. This will load both the thermodynamic and kinetic demo nickel databases. Select the elements nickel, aluminum, and chromium. Select the Phases and Phase Constitution tab and check both boxes next to the disordered FCC phase. Our system is now defined, so click on the Precipitation Calculator node. Change the composition unit to mole percent and set aluminum to 10 and chromium to 10, which automatically sets nickel to 80 mole percent. Next, set the matrix phase to disordered FCC. Set the precipitate phase to FCC L12 number 2. Then change the interfacial energy to user-defined 0.023. Under calculation type, select CCT diagram, the new calculation type in Thermo-Calc 2017B. CCT stands for Continuous Cooling Transformation and allows you to make a calculation which maintains the same cooling rate for the entire time. You simply set starting and ending temperatures and the different rates at which you would like it to cool. Set the minimum temperature to 500 and the maximum to 1200 Kelvin. We will enter several cooling rates for our calculation, so type in 0.01 space 0.1 space 1 space 10 space and 100. We will keep the default stopping criteria of 1e to the negative 4 volume fraction of the gamma prime phase. Our calculation is now set, so select Perform CCT Diagram Simulation at the bottom center of the program. Once the calculation is complete, a plot will appear in the results pane. In this plot, the blue line shows the time it takes for gamma prime to transform at each of the cooling rates according to the stop criteria, which we set as 1e to the negative 4 volume fraction. The cooling rates are represented by the multicolored curved lines. You can also view these results in the form of a table. Right-click on the Precipitation Calculator node, highlight Create New Successor, and select Table Renderer. Right-click on the Table Renderer node, and select Perform Now. Your table will appear in the results pane and shows the same information as the plot. For each cooling rate, the temperature and the time it takes for gamma prime to transform according to the stop criteria, which is a volume fraction of 1e to the negative 4. We hope you found this video useful. We have many other videos available on our website at www.thermocalc.com, or you can click the links currently on your screen.